Hi, let's get some testing started. But before we can test, we need to know what we are going to test. And this usually comes from the requirements. So let's check our requirement. We need to develop a program that tells us whether a year is a leap year or not. A leap year is a year that has one more day in February, so that our calendar is always adjusted with the movement that our planet does around the sun. To calculate this leap year, we have some criteria. A leap year is a year that can be divided by 4 exactly. In other words, if we divide the year by 4 and the remainder is 0, then it is a leap year. However, we have some exceptions. If the year can also be divided by 100 exactly, then it is not a leap year. However, these years can still be leap if they are divided by 400. So, how do we test it? Or how do we make sure that our implementation always correctly returns whether a year is a leap year or not? Often, programs are just too big to be completely tested in a single shot. They have many different cases in which they can fail. The first thing we should do is to break the problem into smaller partitions or classes. Each partition represents a different case that has to be tested. And by different cases, I mean different inputs that are meaningful. For example, if we give 2016 to our program, it has to respond true, yes, this is a leap year. If we generalize this 2016, we are here testing whether the program responds correctly to a year that is divisible by 4 and not divisible by 100. Another partition we can think of is whether our program behaves correctly when our input is a centurial year or a year that ends with a 00, like 1900 or 2000, which are also divisible by 400. The program must then also respond true. Do you get the overall idea? We are really breaking down the program into the different partitions we should test and looking for bugs. Let's keep thinking about partitions, because there are more for this problem. For now, we only thought about our program identifying leap years, but we should also make sure that it can identify years that are not leap years. Can you do it? Pause this video and think about partitions that check if our program correctly identifies non-leap years. A tip. There are 2 more partitions. So, how can we check for non-leap year programs? Let's examine it together. We can see 4 partitions to this program here for a leap year. The first one is years divisible by 4 and not divisible by 100. As concrete examples, years like 2016 or 2020 fall into this partition. Another partition is years divisible by 4, divisible by 100, which would make this year a non-leap year, but it is also divisible by 400, and then it turns back into a leap year. A concrete example is the year 2000. Now, let's explore partitions for non-leap years. If the number is not divisible by 4, the year is not a leap year. For example, 2015 and 2017. Finally, a year that is divisible by 4, divisible by 100, but not divisible by 400, is not a leap year. Examples are 1500 and 1900. Now that we know the partitions, we should make sure that our program behaves correctly in all of them. And let's do this in an automated fashion. Let's write some JUnit tests that will exercise these different partitions.